Quantum world is unpredictable. The behavior of a quantum particle is perplexing. Where Einstein's photoelectric effect pointed out the particle nature of a light wave, the Davison-Germer experiment, on the other hand, demonstrated the wave nature of an electron. It's just like the quantum particles are suffering from a split personality disorder. Quantum mechanics cannot easily be reconciled with everyday language and observations, and hence it has often seemed absurd to physicists as well. So, ever since the notion of quantum physics came into existence, people all over the world have come up with a number of interpretations to explain how things actually work in the eerie quantum world. However, for the better part of the last century, the most accepted explanation for why the same quantum particle may behave in different ways was given by the Copenhagen interpretation. So first of all, let's try to understand what Copenhagen interpretation actually says. The Copenhagen interpretation of quantum mechanics was largely devised from 1925 to 1927 by Niels Bohr and Werner Heisenberg. According to this interpretation, physical systems do not possess definite properties prior to being measured, and quantum mechanics can only predict the probability distribution of a given measurement's possible results. In other words, measurement affects the system, causing it to reduce to only one of the possible values immediately after the measurement. Confused? It's normal to baffle at this point, because this is not what we observe in our daily life scenario. Well, this is where Schrödinger came up with his famous cat experiment to point out a flaw in the Copenhagen interpretation of superposition. Before we begin with this, let me make one thing very clear to you. The Schrödinger's cat experiment was not a real activity carried out in any lab. Rather, it was a thought experiment that was devised by Austrian physicist Erwin Schrödinger in 1935. Though the idea originated from Albert Einstein, Schrödinger designed it to show what the Copenhagen interpretation would look like if the mathematical terminology used to explain superposition in the microscopic world was replaced by macroscopic terms that an average person could visualize and understand. In this famous thought experiment, a cat is placed in a steel box along with a Geiger counter, a vial of poison, a hammer, and a radioactive substance as shown. When the radioactive substance decays, the Geiger counter detects it and then triggers the hammer to release the poison, which subsequently kills the cat. But radioactive decay is a random process, and there is no way to predict when will it happen. So the atom kind of exists in a state of superposition, both decayed and not decayed at the same time. Until the box is opened and an observation is made, an observer doesn't know whether the cat is alive or dead. This is because the cat's fate is tied to whether or not the atom has decayed. The cat ends up being both dead and alive at the same time. But the existence of a cat that is both dead and alive at the same time is quite absurd and does not happen in the real world, right? So, this thought experiment showed that collapse of all possible outcomes to merely one outcome is not just driven by conscious observers or measurements. There is something more to the collapses. This means that as soon as the radioactive atom will interact with the Geiger counter, it will collapse from its non-decayed or decayed state into one definite state. The Geiger counter will either get definitely triggered and the cat would die, or the Geiger counter would not get triggered at all and the cat would not die. But what would not happen simultaneously? So, quantum state collapse is not driven just by conscious observers or measurements. Schrödinger's cat was just a teaching tool invented by Schrödinger to make this fact more obvious and simpler to grasp. Undoubtedly, the role of the observer and the measurements remain an important question in the study of quantum physics, and is an endless source of speculations, especially in the field of quantum computation. Still, throughout the years, the Schrödinger's cat analogy has been one of the best analogies used to illustrate the emerging theories of how quantum mechanics works.